It was the 1992 Olympics in Barcelona. 65,000 fans streamed into the stadium, and millions more were viewing from around the world as 19-year-old Derek Redmond's race time finally approached. After years of training and severe injuries, Derek was ready to realize his lifelong dream of earning a gold medal in the 400-meter dash. He knelt down into position, the gun fired, and Derek shot off in an unbelievable start. He was at a world record time when he saw the finish line. Derek was a definite win. And then it happened. Derek heard a pop. He felt an excruciating pain in his leg. His Achilles tendon had just torn, his leg shaking. He started hopping on one leg, and then he fell to the track, screaming in agony. All the years, the sweat, the pain, the sacrifices, all of his training had come down to this moment. And as he laid there on the ground in agony, he watched the other runners run past him, and he knew his dream was dead. The paramedics rushed to Derek with a stretcher, but he waved them off. No way! I'm not getting on the stretcher. I'm finishing this race. He struggled to his feet, and he felt the sharp pain of the torn tendon surge through his body. And with each pain-filled step, the crowd began to cheer for him, louder and louder, building into a thunderous roar. But after exhaustive efforts, he was still far from the finish line. And then, from the top of the stands, a man is rushing through the crowd. He reaches the bottom of the stands. He jumps over the railing. He dodges an Olympic security guard and ran onto the track. He finally reaches Derek, and he wraps his arm around his waist. Derek initially tried to push him away, but then he heard his father say, "Derek, it's me. You don't have to do this." "Yes, I do," Derek said. "Well then," his dad said, "we're going to finish this together." Derek put his arms around his father's shoulders and they sobbed. Together, arm in arm, father and son struggled toward the finish line with 65,000 people cheering, clapping, and crying. Derek was determined to keep going, despite not knowing what good could possibly come from completing the race. Only later did he discover that millions of hearts and minds worldwide were inspired by what would later become known as one of the most inspiring moments in history. Persevering despite a lack of hope. That's the story of Hanukkah. The incredibly powerful Syrian Greek army were plowing through Israel, forcing the Jews to convert or die. And one family of righteous, humble Kohanim, high priests, known as the Maccabees, attempted to undertake the impossible. With no military expertise, against all odds, they engaged tens of thousands of Syrian Greek soldiers in a battle that had little hope. They fought because of what they believed in, without knowing how or even if they would succeed. But like Derek's dad, God supported them, and he was at their side until they crossed the finish line and won the war. We all have dreams. We have dreams we want to achieve. But we give up because they seem hopeless. Perhaps it's mending a relationship, starting a new career, or even becoming a more patient person. This Hanukkah, choose something you really want to accomplish. Identify what's holding you back, and then in spite of it, do it anyway. And then look to God to help you cross the finish line.